God, let me ask you a question that has been asked of me many times back to Apple. And the reasons why Apple is not using local suppliers, vendors, in the construction and parts of building their facility. And response back to them, I know that they have guidelines as to who can and cannot work on projects like this, but could you explain how that works without them, what they're doing?
Gladly. I think the statement that they're not using local vendors is completely wrong.
Well, it is the perception.
Ask Roger Kerr and the number of trucks that he's had in and out of that facility over recent weeks is 24/7 has been pretty phenomenal. Certainly, I have been asked that question a lot, and the answer is that when possible, and this was an agreement that we forged with the company, that whenever possible, they were going to use local vendors and suppliers and contractors and services, and that's actually in the contract. The reality of that came when we realized that there are only, this is the biggest privately built data center in the world. There's only so many people that have the capabilities of building this facility as quickly as they have needed it to be built. And so there were only one or two contractors, for example, that had the general contractors that had the ability to build this thing. And certainly the planning process that they've gone through, they tried to use as many local contractors and suppliers as sub-vendors as they could, and there have been quite a few that have been used. I think we'll certainly continue to encourage that in all incentive agreements from here on out to try and make sure, if possible, not get in the way of the free enterprise system, because we want people to be able to choose the right contractor for their services, but we also want to continue to encourage as much as possible local impacts. And that's specifically why I mentioned early in my comments about the impacts that this community is feeling as a result of that project. And believe me, I'm convinced that there is a lot more behind the curtain going on and will go on. Today at 1 o'clock, I think Apple is going to announce something that will probably be of interest to a lot of folks in this room. And for job stability, go out and buy one of those new tablets.
Question for Scott. Scott, can you list the top three reasons that Apple and Google chose this area to locate it?
Well, and we're trying to brand this area as North Carolina's Data Center Corridor. The reason Apple and Google located here, the reason Google located here most likely was the ability of the facility to be served by Big Power. And that was really a legacy of the furniture industry in Lenoir and having huge power availability to the area. But not only that, huge water and things like that that are required. I think Apple chose this one because it had been slightly validated by Google and enough to get their curiosity, and that's why we make an argument that other folks are going to follow behind. But also because we had a product that was developed specifically for data centers. And rather than just a general business park, we had a data center-oriented park. And not to say we wouldn't have sold it to a titanium manufacturer or somebody else like that had they come along, but the fact that we had this park that was developed specifically for that purpose was a big draw. Not to mention the cheaper power rates, the interest of the community. We already had packaged incentives and things like that ready for the company. We were marketing specifically to that sector. And that's why I'm strongly advocating looking at the smart grid sector and trying to marry up our communications with expertise with our manufacturing